Hi and welcome back. In today's video, we are going to briefly talk about Revit phases and how to export them to IFC. I've received a ton of questions around this topic and also especially about how to export the demolished objects to IFC. Unfortunately, spoiler alert, this is not really possible, but there is a pretty nice way how to visualize the demolished elements in a viewer which supports the version compare, such as the Autodesk docs, for example. But let's start from the beginning. In the first part of the video, I will briefly explain you what Revit phases are, and we will build a very simple model to be used for testing the IFC export. If you are familiar with Revit phases, feel free to skip this part. In the second part, then, we'll see how we can export the phases and which settings are available to exactly manage which elements will be exported. Building up on this, I will explain in more detail how you can use the Autodesk docs to display the demolished element as such. Last but not least, we'll have a brief look at how to attach information about the phases to each of the elements. So let's get started. I'm using the default metric template in Revit, and I'll simply draw a couple of walls from scratch. If you have a closer look at the view properties, you'll see that there is a phase already preset here. This means all elements I draw in this view will automatically be assigned to this phase. When I select one of my walls, you can see its phase in the properties, which is, in this case, new construction, just as a view. You can set up the phases the way you need them through the settings available from the Manage tab. Phases can be used for a variety of use cases and are not limited to renovation projects only. Actually, they are a great way to divide a model into construction stages, and you can add as many phases as you need. The second most important setting are the phase filters, which can be used to drive the visibility of the phases in your Revit views. This means, depending on the current phase set in your view, you can decide how the new, existing, demolished, or temporary elements will be displayed. Last but not least, the graphic overrides are used to drive the visual appearance of the phased elements in your view. Now that I successfully confused you, let's jump back to Revit and have a look at how we can model elements with different phases. First of all, I'll select my previously modeled walls and change their phase to existing. This is something you can do at any point without any side effects. If I change the phase of my current view to existing before placing an element, it will automatically be assigned to the same phase as well. Now, let's create a custom phase filter. In Germany, we use a particular way to display phases in renovation projects, so I'll simply create a new filter and select graphic override for new elements, no override for the existing ones, as we are not going to change them, and also an override for the demolished elements. The temporary elements, by the way, are elements which you create and demolish in the same phase. Now that we have set up these, we'll go to the graphic overrides and change some settings. Please note that these settings affect all your phase filters, so be careful when changing them. In Germany, we override the demolished elements with yellow colors, and I'll set a yellow pattern for both the projection and cut surfaces. For new, we'll do the same with red color. When I go to my view now, I can select the phase filter. Of course, nothing will happen because currently we only have the existing elements in this view and these are not overridden. However, when I select an element in Revit, I can demolish it using the sledgehammer from the Modify tab, one of my favorite tools in Revit. And notice that it will be instantly overridden with the yellow color, which is, of course, not super visible on my fancy black background, but I'm sure you get the point. Also, if I demolish a door, notice that the door itself will turn yellow. However, the portion of the wall which needs to be closed after the door has been demolished turns red because this portion of the wall is new. If I place a new wall, It will be automatically overridden with my view filter, and I can of course use this filter also in a 3D view. If we place a new door, Revit will also automatically demolish the portion of the wall needed for the wall opening. Now you can go ahead and use the face filter to display only particular phases, or also use them in schedules to exactly track how much demolished and new materials and elements we have in our model. Now that we know how to use phases in Revit, let's go ahead and export them to IFC. When you are exporting to IFC, notice that on the General Settings tab, you can select which phase to export. This can be default depending on your view, or you can manually select one of the phases. Let's go ahead and export the existing phase first. As you can see in the OpenIFC viewer, these are only the elements we initially created in the first phase, which actually makes sense. Now let's export the new construction. As you can see, these are now all elements that still exist in the new construction phase, meaning the existing ones and the new ones minus the demolished ones. I'm often asked how to export the demolished elements, and this is really kind of problematic because actually they don't exist anymore and there is not really a good way to integrate demolished objects into IFC. This is why I would always recommend you to export phases one by one and then use version compare in the Autodesk docs to view the differences. For this, you will need to export the existing phase, upload it to the cloud, then export the new phase using the same file name, and then upload it to the same folder and override the old file. This will automatically create a new version of your file, and you will then be able to compare these versions, which will also visually indicate all elements that have been changed, added, or removed. What do you think of this method? Did you know about it? And does it support your workflow? And by the way, if you have an Autodesk AEC collection license, then you automatically have free access to the Autodesk docs and the version compare. Another thing I would like to remind you of is the importance of data. We have successfully exported our phased elements. However, they have no information about the phase they were created in so far. So let's quickly add that. As you probably already know, there are three ways to export the properties from Revit, and we will have a quick look at them. The first and the most simple one is to export all the Revit properties, which I, however, don't really recommend as it will export a lot of other information which you don't really need outside of Revit. For testing purposes, I like to use the schedules because they are quite easy to configure. Simply create a schedule, preferably add IFC or PSET to the title to avoid exporting all of your schedules later, and then add the properties you want to export. When exporting, remember to set the checkbox and also limit the export to schedules depending on their title. This will create a new PSET in your IFC file. The third and the best option, however, is using the custom property sets, which require a mapping file. In the template that comes with Revit, you can find the exact instructions on how to specify your PSET. Remember to separate the entries with a tab and not with spaces, as this file is quite sensitive when it comes to that. This is why I like using the Notepad++, which displays all characters, including symbols for tabs. After specifying the name of the property sets, we set the I for the instance property. And after this, the IFC classes this PSET should be applied to. Just a quick reminder, if you are uncertain to which classes you should assign your PSET. In the Building Smart documentation, you can simply browse through the alphabetical listing to find your element, in this case, a wall, and view its hierarchy in the IFC schema. As you can see here, we could assign this PSET to the wall only, but we could also go one step above and select the IFC building element to assign it also to other building elements like our doors. Therefore, we'll go ahead with the IFC building element and specify properties. Of course, take care not to make any typos here. In the second column, we need to specify the data type. You can find a list of all supported data types at the top of the text file. In the case of information preset by Revit, this is often label, but in this case, text word also works, so it's up to you. When you now export, we will see our newly created PSET in the IFC Viewer. And keep in mind that Revit only exports the properties with values, therefore walls which have not been demolished won't have this property. That's it for today. Actually, this was supposed to be just a quick video, but I'm afraid it turned out a little bit longer. Anyway, I hope it was useful for you. See you soon.